Hello, welcome to a new video of Gespy Beeldstaaf. This video is about this machine. As you can see, the top of this machine is an original Atari 600 XL. But if you do look at the back, then we see it has a different back. It has a HDMI, USB. So, what's inside this machine? I'm going to show you this in this video. Let's start! Okay, what is this? Well, inside is a Raspberry Pi. And on this Raspberry Pi runs an Atari emulator. And connected to the USB port of this Raspberry Pi is the original Atari keyboard, fully functioning. So, how did I build this? Let's see. It starts with this keyboard that I bought back in the 80s in an electronics dump store. I used this keyboard as an external keyboard for my other computer. Connect a very long flat cable to it and a power switch on the top. I used it on this computer. This is my original Atari 800XA that I used. And I connected this computer with the monitor connection to a monochrome monitor and with the RF output to a color TV. And that color TV connection I used to play video games. Only that TV was on the other side of the room. So I've added an extra keyboard connection to the 800XL and I connect this 600XL keyboard to that. Then I can use this keyboard on the other side of the room for games that use that keyboard input. But that was then. Now I have this keyboard laying around for years. Always planning to do something with it. So I came up with a plan. What if I could build a Raspberry Pi inside of it and run Atari emulator on that Raspberry Pi? I still have that old Raspberry Pi 1 laying around doing nothing, so I can use that for it. I'm going to use the Atari 800 emulator to emulate the Atari XL. It runs on Linux, so I can use it on the Raspberry Pi. On the Raspberry Pi, I'm going to install Raspberry Pi OS Lite. That's a light version of Linux without the desktop software, because I don't need that. So, let's start. I have this keyboard, but that's only half part of the case. So, I have to make a new bottom case to fit the Raspberry Pi. And I don't need this very long flat cable. So let's cut it in a smaller parts. And I don't need this big ugly power switch. I have a bit of regret I ever built it in, because now I have a hole in my Atari case. So what am I going to do with that? Well, I will make up something. First, I'm going to test if this keyboard is still functioning. So I'm going to strip some wires so we can see keys are working. I found this schema of an Atari XL keyboard online. This is very handy. Now I don't have to figure out myself all the connections. Let's test if the keyboard works. Ah, well, seems like it's working. Let's test another one. Okay. That's great. The Let's also test the function keys, like the start and select button. Yeah, they also work. To connect the keyboard to the USB of the Raspberry Pi, I'm going to use a Teensy microcontroller. That's some kind of Arduino controller, and, but more advanced. It has lots of input output, and it has a fully functioning USB port that can work as a HID device, so it can be used as keyboard, mouse, or joystick. I found this Python source code online for the Teensy that can be used with an Atari keyboard. You can define all your keys and which button is must simulate, and here you have a loop that checks which keys are pressed, and according to the pressed key, it's going to send the right key code to the USB port. I've uploaded the source code to the Teensy controller and placed the controller on a breadboard, and now I'm wiring its input-output to the keyboard. So let's see if it works. Wow, actually works. This is really great. Okay. Let's also test it with the built-in keyboard test tool of Atari. Yeah, those keys work great. Now I'm going to make the final connection to the keyboard. I've placed the Teensy controller on a bigger board, so I can add a connector for the keyboard to it. Okay, that's connected. Now let's add the connector for the keyboard. I'm going to use the head connector for that. That keyboard connector has to be connected to the input-output ports of the Teensy controller. I'm going to do that by soldering 24 wires between that. So, that's done. 24 wires. And this is the final result. On the keyboard side, I'm going to press print connector to the flat cable. And now let's test this. So the print connector goes to the Teensy board. And one of the USB ports of the Raspberry Pi goes to the USB port of the Teensy controller. And let's see. Yep, that works great. Okay, now I'm going to test this with the keyboard test tool. So, bye. Here is the test tool. Go to keyboard and go to test everything. But I have to make some adjustments, because on the Atari keyboard, the arrow keys are combined with other keys, and you can use that keys if you press Ctrl on one of those keys. So I have to change the Python source code for this. The source code, I'm going to check if the Ctrl key is pressed. If that's the key case, then I'm going to send a different code to the keyboard controller. Let's also test the arrow keys. Yep, that works. Great. Now the USB ports. I also want to add more USB ports to the Mac. For that I bought this mini USB hub. I tried this on the Raspberry Pi, but it didn't quite work because the Raspberry Pi does not deliver enough power for this USB hub. So I have to change something about it. So we have a separate data input and power input. So I'm going to open it to see if that's possible. Okay, it's pretty small. How am I going to fit that in the case? Well, I'm going to remove that USB cable and make two new connections, one for data and one for power. And I'm going to place it on a bigger printboard that has four holes, so I can fit it in the case. I've removed the USB connectors of the hub and placed it on the bigger board. And I've placed two connectors for data and power. Then I soldered some wires on the place where the old connectors were to connect them to the new connectors. Then I placed the hub on the new board and soldered all the wires. And this is the result. It has three USB connectors at the back, and it has one USB connector on the other side for future expansions inside the case, and it has a separate data connector and power connector. So that was in theory. Now we have to test if this actually works. So here's the data cable that goes to the USB port of the Raspberry Pi. And here is a power connector that goes to the power adapter. For testing, I'm going to use this gamepad that I'm going to connect to the USB port. And on the Raspberry Pi, I'm going to start the game to test if the USB port works. Okay, let's test it. Yes, it works. Yeah, this is a happy jumper. Now I have all the components in place, I'm going to continue with the case. I still have to build that bottom box. I'm going to use a metal plate for that, that I'm going to shape in a bottom plate for the Atari XL. We'll be right back. And this is the result. It was a bit harder than I thought of. And yeah, the result is not perfect, but it will do. Now we can continue with the next step. The next thing is the hole we still have in the top case. I have decided to use that to add an extra function key to the Atari. Okay, this is done. Now, that doesn't look really bad. Oh, I can live with that. Like most Rater computers, the white part of this case is a little bit yellowed. First I thought I'd give it a retro bright, but there's another solution. I can also give it some spray paint in exactly the same color as the bottom part. So let's try that. First impression is good, but let's remove the tape to see the final result. Not bad at all. Way better than retro writing. I think that's a pretty good solution. And now the final step. Let's install all the components, starting with the Raspberry Pi. Okay, everything's inside. Here you see the Raspberry Pi, USB hub, keyboard controller, network connection, micro USB for power, and the headphone connector, and the power switch. Before we close the case, I'm going to test if everything works. So, here we have the HDMI that we connect to the Raspberry Pi, the USB of the game controller that goes to the USB hub, and the power supply that goes to the micro USB. Yeah, okay. Let's turn it on. Do we have everything? Yes. Now we wait. Yeah, here it is. Let's test the keyboard. Yeah, that works. Now that it works, we can close the case. Let's see. Keyboard cable has to be very careful with. It's a perfect fit. Now we're going to place the screws in the bottom. Now you have seen how I have made this, let me give you a demo so you can see what this machine can do. Okay, let's start the demo. I'm going to switch on the machine. Yeah, the LED is working, but now we wait, because that's the only downside. It takes a while to boot, way longer than the original Atari. But in the meanwhile, you can enjoy this nice loading screen. Oh, there it is. Okay. It It loads with Atari Basic, just like an original Atari XL. Let's make a small demo in Basic, a world famous Hello World demo. So that works. Now let's go on a DOS, because you don't need a disk drive for this. It has a built-in disk drive in the SD card. That's very nice. And it has this extra button. Let's press that button and see what happens. Then we go to the emulator menu, where you can do all kinds of stuff. Like the disk drive management, where you can assign up to 8 disk drives. Or we can go to settings. In settings, you can choose what type of machine you want to emulate. Now it's 800XL, but you can change it to any type machine, even the 5200K machine. And we can change the memory size. This is very cool. We can increase it up to 1 MB. Well, what can we do? We can insert the cartridge, not the original cartridge, but a cartridge file. So let's pick up a game. Which one shall I choose? Oh, wait, River Raid, that's my all-time favorite. Okay, let's start the game by resetting the machine. Okay, that was the game. What else can we do? Well, all kinds of things that the original Atari did not can do, like save state or load the state of a game. And of course, you can do more than just this Atari emulator. Because if we exit the emulator, we are in Linux. So if we log in, we have a Linux machine, and there we can do all kinds of things. Install other software, even other emulators, because you have a full Linux. Okay, this was it. I hope you liked the video. I'm going to continue with converting all those floppy disks to image files, so I can place it on one single SD card to put in the machine. If you want to see more videos like this, you can go to my channel, GESPI Build Stuff, down below. And don't forget to like this video. Bye!